Yeah. How much time do we have to get started? You've shaded everybody, right? 3 minutes?
Yeah.
This is yours truly, Dr. Charles Ndifon. And I'm so excited. I'm just enjoying a great worship here by Sister Sinach. Oh, it's called Shout It Loud. My goodness, I am so excited you joined me today. Thank you for joining me. And I see a lot of you have been already on. We're just giving everybody a chance to join us. We have Claire. Hallelujah. God bless you. I'm looking forward to interacting with you. We have Pastor Esther Perez. Pastor Esther, we love you. Thank you for joining me. Hallelujah. We have Elaine. God bless you. Hallelujah. We have Roland. God bless you. And we have Apostle Teresia. God bless you. All the way from Dallas, Texas. I guess from Kenya to Dallas, Texas. Love you. We have Frederick. We have Chuki Buka. God bless you. We have our esteemed Princess Reka. And we have Chris from Dexter, Iowa. Bless you, Chris. Hallelujah. We have Princess Lucy, all the way from Nairobi, Kenya. And I see Kathy from Canada. God bless you. And we have Ig, all the way from Denmark. My goodness. We have Finman. God bless you. Hello. We have Emmanuel Paul, all the way from Austria. God bless you. And we have Emmett. God bless you. Love you, love you, love you. I wanted to share this with everybody. Today is going to be a hot one. It's going to be an exciting one. I tell you, I feel something coming on. Yesterday, actually, sometime this morning, Apostle Everton was on sharing some amazing truths and a great thing God is doing in Dubai. And I was just going through some of the videos from the last meeting in Nigeria. Tremendous, tremendous miracles. Words cannot fully describe what God did in Nigeria. And some of you didn't know that the meetings in Nigeria extended for an extra day because God was moving so mightily, but we had to leave. We had to come back and set up for all the things God had to do with us. But I'm telling you, it has been glorious what God has been doing. Thank you for joining us. Glory to His name. Praise God. I see Benson. I see Augie. God bless you. And Pastor Laurie. Hallelujah. I have Pauline all the way from Greenland. Let me know where you're watching from. I am so excited. I am so excited. We have Carola. God bless you. So we are going to be doing an amazing thing. I'm talking about today. The topic is unleashing prayer power. Unleashing prayer power. Prayer power unleashed. That's what I want to talk about this week. What it means to pray with faith. Hallelujah. To pray and get maximum result. We have Benson all the way from South Africa. I love you. And Pastor Lori joining from Washington, D.C. Praise God. Now, I'll be talking about some amazing things today. Just to encourage your heart about prayer. I was enjoying this song so much for the last half an hour. Just been in my spirit. In fact, all night, that song has been in my heart. Shout It Loud by Sinach. It has been tremendous. But I'm glad you joined me today. We're talking about unleashing prayer power. And I want you to get your friends and let them know that the doctor is in the house. And we are going to be doing some amazing spiritual surgery today. And we're going to be debunking some of the things that people sometimes are to pray and why you don't get results. But you're going to be learning a lot of things today. How to pray with faith. How to pray with faith. So get yourself ready. It is going to be explosive. It's going to be exciting. Thank you all for joining me today. Thank you all for joining me today. So I am looking forward to sharing with you. Tonight, we are going to be in Taunton, Massachusetts. We are going to be in Taunton, Massachusetts with Apostle Kotz, Ivan Kotz. We're going to be there today. It is going to be a glorious time of miracle signs and wonders. You cannot miss it. It is the Greater Boston District Conference. Let the Lord carry you. That's the theme. And I'll be sharing tonight at the Cathedral of Life. It is 336 Weir Street in Taunton, Massachusetts. If you're in the Massachusetts area, you need to come on. It is, you can see the address is there and it's on the screen. And then the phone number is 617-427-8975. Apostle Ivan Kotz is our host. And it is going to be exciting. We are expecting a lot of people tonight. And we're just going to go for miracles, signs, and wonders. Unleashing prayer power. Do you realize a lot of people don't understand the importance of prayer? By the way, I want to encourage you. You need to register for the Power School that's coming up very soon. A lot of people have been asking me. There's been so much interest in the Power School. So many people are excited about Power School. And remember what I said to you yesterday. I said that, you know, when you pray to God, you know, it's not something stressful. But remember to register for Power School, psom.org. It is going to be phenomenal. The message God has given me for this Power School is very, 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 very strategic in the now. And it's a now word that is going to propel you to another dimension. It's going to propel you to another dimension. So, of course, you know, we just came back from Nigeria. It was tremendous. Again, I want to thank all the wonderful people in Nigeria that are part of the winning team, the Love Revolution Army team. God is doing something fresh, something good, and something creative with all these amazing people that we meet around the world. So thank you for joining us today. I see Lola Day. Blessings to you. And I have Pops Thomas all the way from, I believe, Durban, South Africa. God bless you. And Vanessa all the way from Kelowna. And we have Pepithua. Is it from Australia? God bless you. Thank you from... Oh my goodness, Princess Limo. Princess Lucy says she's the anesthesiologist. Anesthesiologist. Okay, good. I was trying to read what you wrote. Oh my goodness, Johnny, God bless you. John Paul from Uganda, God bless you. I don't want to miss anybody today. And I'll be talking about some strategy, understanding how to unleash prayer power. How to pray with faith. I tell you, it is great to have faith. It is great to have faith. All other grounds is sinking sand. Standing on Jesus, on the words of our Lord. I'm telling you, it is exciting. So I'm going to kick this off and express here. Riziki, God bless you. This is going to be great. Now, how do we pray with faith? Number one, to Christ we come. Number two, God is not dumb. Number three, behold Jesus. Number four, see the finished work. Number five, it's for everyone. Number six, add all that he has done. Number seven, release the power of your words. Number eight, mark the enemy. Identify the enemy. Number nine, learn to shun taboos and traditions. Number 10, you shake the gloom. Anything that has been on you, any gloom, anything, any negative thing on you, you shake it off. Hallelujah. And number 11, start having fun. Number 12, know that you have already won. Number 13, then you get going with the resources. Okay, now, seems like I'm having fun and joking. So maybe I read that too quickly. And we have Pastor Peter, Pastor TV Peters. God bless you, all the way from Port Hacker. Now, what am I talking about? When I talk about prayer, we have made prayer to be such a ritualistic thing, and we seem like it's a chore to pray. When you understand what prayer really is, it changes how you interact with God. Hallelujah. So we are trying to demystify prayer. Maybe I read that too quickly. I don't know whether you want me to read that again. I said, how do you pray with faith? Number one, you come to Christ. Number two, God speaks. Number three, behold Jesus. Look at Jesus and keep that as your focus. Number four, you see what he has done. Number five, he is for everyone. This good news is for everyone. God wants to listen to you. Like I said yesterday, you don't come to God because you want something. You come to him because he wants to hear you. Hallelujah. It changes how we pray. It changes everything we do about prayer. You find the prayer becomes an exciting encounter, an exciting time with God. Hallelujah. I said number six, know the totality of what he has done. Number seven, you release the power of your tongue. Number eight, mark the enemy. Identify the enemy and take him out. Number nine, learn to shun traditions and choose glad news. That's what I'm talking about. Number 10, shake yourself, stir up the power of God within you, and you're ready for something extra. Now, I'm going through this, and you're wondering what this has got to do with prayer. You will learn in a short time. It has everything to do with prayer. I don't know whether you're ready for me today, but I am ready to roll this morning. Hallelujah. Prayer power. I am excited about what God is going to do today. So I hope that you are all ready for what God has in store for us today. Amen. So I'm going to go through some of those things very quickly with you. That way we can be on the same page. I said prayer is not trying to get God's attention. You already have His attention. Hallelujah. You already have His attention. You are not trying to have His attention. Hallelujah. You already have His attention. So when I pray because I know I am being heard. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4, we're going to read that again from yesterday. Hebrews chapter 4, we're going to look from verse 12 to 16. And we're going to look at that again. I want to make sure we can go through a few things very quickly. Hallelujah. Hebrews 4, verse 12 to 16. It says, for the word of God is quick, powerful, and sharper than a two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul, and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart. Neither is there anything or any creature that is not made manifest in the sight. But all things are naked and open unto the eyes of Him with whom we have to do. Come on, can I talk to you folks today? I want to bring something to your attention. Something amazing that you are going to get a hold of right now. This point, hallelujah. Chris, we'll get back to that. We'll talk to you about that. I said, number one, to Christ will come. Number two, God is not dumb. Number three, behold Jesus. He is your focus. Hallelujah. Now, let me get to this. The Bible says nothing. It said neither, verse 13 says, neither is there any creature that is not manifest in His sight. Neither is there any creature that is not made known in His sight. Listen to that scripture again. We read the Bible very quickly and don't get it. The Bible says, nothing is hid from the Word. If you are the Word, you can discern the thoughts and the intent of the heart, and nothing is hid from you. No creature is hid from you. But all things are naked and open unto the eyes of Him that we have to do. The one we deal with has the inside secret to everything we need. Hallelujah. I hope you get what I'm talking about. Oh my goodness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Alexander, bless you. I see blessing Jacobs. God bless you, man of God. Now, the reason I'm saying this is when you understand prayer, it changes everything you do. Prayer is not an option. It is the lifestyle of the believer. You have been given this unfettered access to communicate to the one who made everything. What am I talking to you about? I'm talking to you about that everything is open to the eyes of Him with whom we have to do. Everything, all things are naked. All things are naked and open to His eyes. If you have His eyes, everything is open to you. The one you deal with, the one you come to, He knows everything about everyone, every situation, and everything. In prayer, you have an insight into all of this. In prayer, you come to God and you hear Him speak, and then you look at your example, Jesus, and my goodness, you begin to find out what is already finished. You begin to understand that everything you need to succeed has already been made available to you. When I come in prayer, I do not waste my energy trying to get God's attention. I already have His attention.
I'm not trying to get something from God. He has given me all things that pertain unto life, unto godliness. I just need to have the keys that can unleash it. I see Olabisi Hughes. Hallelujah. Welcome. Welcome, woman of God. Hallelujah. I am so glad you joined me today. Now, what am I talking about? I'm talking about unleashing prayer power. Unleashing prayer power. What happens to you when you understand prayer? The Bible declares praying always with all kinds of prayers. Praying always with all kinds of prayers. And the Bible says pray without ceasing. It tells us to pray without ceasing. Praying, there are different kinds of prayers. So when you communicate, there are different kinds of prayers. But let's look at this in verse 14. Seeing then we have a great high priest that has passed into the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession. For we have not a high priest who cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sins. Let us therefore come boldly. That is the invitation given to you. God is saying to you, whether you're a sinner, whether you're a saint, he said, come boldly unto the throne of grace, and that we may obtain mercy. My goodness, do you know there is mercy for you today? Do you realize that God has everything set up for you, regardless of what you've done wrong? You come boldly and you can obtain mercy. He didn't say you obtain mercy and then you come boldly. You come boldly with an assurance in your heart that you're being heard by your loving Father. When you understand that, it changes everything else you are doing. Hallelujah. You know without a shadow of doubt that God hears you clearly. Hallelujah. I see Pastor Brian is on. I'm talking about understanding why you pray. Understanding how to pray. How to pray with faith. Verse 16. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace. That is the invitation given. Let us come boldly unto the throne of grace. Let us come boldly unto the throne of grace. I'm repeating this so that it can stick into your mind, into your heart, into your spirit, into your being. Come boldly to God. When I come to God, I never come as a beggar or a cowering slave. I come as somebody that is completely free of all the religious encumbrances. I see heavenly is on. I'm glad you joined us today. Wow. Let us come boldly. I see people come to God the way religion makes it look like God is mad at you, or maybe God is going to do something. I don't share those things. When I come, I tell people sometimes, when I share my take on things, somebody said once to me, I said, how come when you talk about Jesus, it sounds like you know he a different person than most people do? I said, it could be true, because the Jesus you experience is the Jesus you will express. The Jesus you experience is the Jesus you will express. The God of the Bible now becomes the God in me. The Christ that was walking with them, with Peter, James, and John, now becomes the Christ that lives in Charles today and going about doing good and helping and making the world a better place. I pray today that every limitation, every guilt, and every shame that you've had that has kept you from coming boldly to the throne of grace be removed from you in the name of Jesus. I decree today you're walking out in absolute victory in the name of Jesus. Now, you see, prayer never changes anything. Because if prayer changed things, every person that prayed would have had something different in their life. How come one of the biggest scandals in the church that people don't talk about is not sometimes what they call sexual immorality or some people doing some crazy thing? The biggest scandal in church I come to realize is the scandal of unanswered prayers. Why are people's prayers not answered? You see, a lot of times people do not understand that the Bible says you ask, you pray and you ask amiss. In other words, you miss how to ask. Why? Number one, because the reason you're not receiving is because you're not asking. You see, you have not because you ask not. The second thing is because you don't know. You're asking because you are asking to fulfill your lust instead of fulfilling purpose. You see, those are the things why sometimes people miss. James chapter 4 verses 1 to 4 tells us exactly that. But we have, the believers have the weapons that guarantees results. We have the weapons that guarantee results, that whenever we pray, we can have an answer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So what am I saying? See, a lot of times people don't understand that the Jesus that walked in them, walked with them, now is the Jesus that lives in you. Hallelujah. The Jesus of the sacred book called the Bible is now the Jesus in the sacred life called Charles, called Alexander, called you, called Laurie. Hallelujah. He lives in the book called you. Hallelujah. Okay, let me give you, I just got something fun. You're going to have fun with this. Do you know that Jesus, a lot of people have Jesus in this book. They have Jesus in the book called the Bible. Now you have Jesus in this living book called you. Hallelujah. You are a living epistle. You are a living book. The truth of God is wrapped up in you. When you pray, you unleash that truth into the world. You have a revelation of who lives in you, and then you can go out and make the world a better place. You come boldly onto the throne of grace, that you may obtain mercy and find grace. Two things. You obtain mercy. First of all, come boldly. For what reason? To obtain mercy. That means you are no longer guilty. When you come to God, don't come with a guilt mentality. Come with a love mentality. You come to God. To Christ, you come. If you want to come to God, you come through Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can do all things through Christ. Through God, you can do anything through Christ. Hallelujah. And then you understand, number two, God is not dumb. In other words, God speaks. When you pray, God answers. Believe that. Believe that God answers. I expect answers when I talk to my Father. I expect him to give me instruction. God is not being quiet and is staying there, that you cannot reach him, that you cannot, cannot get to him. That is not true. That's what religion does. But the key is, do you know how to guarantee what you're getting, the results you're getting? Hallelujah. I'll be sharing this with you this week so that you can have a better understanding that when you come to him, you have absolute confidence he will hear you. God wants to hear you. It's one thing to say, I hear a lot of times people say, well, I want to get a word from the man of God. The man of God, the woman of God, is not your fax machine. Of course, I believe in the prophetic word. I believe in giving you word. The reason I'm teaching you is so that you can grow into the fullness of what God had in mind for you to be. That's the whole idea. So that you can be a full-grown, mature believer, putting the devil out of business. Not always depending on somebody else's prayer, but you can say to the devil, back off and take a number and watch me win. Hallelujah. You've got to understand that it has to be a different attitude when you come to God. But I hear people that pray a lot of times and they said, I pray for many hours. I smile. They ask me the question, you move with such power of God. How do you have this? How can you know this? You know, I remember, I think 2 days ago, Apostle Everton was sharing in Dubai about the first encounter he had with me and how his life was changed. When we came to the hospital and this lady, her leg was about to be amputated. They were about to amputate the leg in half an hour. So when I came from the airport, I was very tired. I came from the east coast of the United States to the west coast, to Vancouver, British Columbia. So when I got there, I was kind of tired and hungry, but the pastors took me immediately that took me immediately to the hospital. That was the first place I went to. And so when I went there, they told me this lady is very vital to the church. She's a wonderful lady that has been very supportive of the work of God. They said, can we just stop by the hospital? It was a desperate situation. When we got there, it was amazing. It was simply fantastic. I was tired. I wasn't feeling spiritual. I wasn't praying. But I'm talking about, you don't pray when you get to the occasion. You are prayed up before you get to the occasion. You don't go to the miracle meeting and then you want to pray. Too late. Jesus never, he comes to the people and tells them, Father, I know you hear me always. In other words, I'm not trying to pray to you, but just to show those people my connection with you, I'm going to do something. Lazarus, come forth. In other words, the preparation is your prayer lifestyle. Before you make contact with people, you make contact with headquarters. That's what you're supposed to do. Before you make contact with people, you make contact with headquarters. Hallelujah. Now, this is what happened. This lady was laying in bed, and Apostle Everton was there, and his pastor at the time was there. He was a nice Bible college student, and he was just busy, basically. He was basically looking and wondering, who is this? Who is this young man? Who is this guy from Africa? And he, you know, he was kind of watching, because I look back at some of the pictures from those meetings. My goodness, there's about 21 years ago. We go a long way back, man. It was wild. Do you know what happened? You see, I was so tired, I wasn't thinking. I just waved my hand over the body, the ladies from the top to the bottom. As I waved my hand, there was a light that looked like a photocopying machine. Apostle Everton saw it, the pastor saw it. It started scanning this woman from the top. It wasn't like we were trying to be spiritual, it was a physical light that was going from the top of her head, just going all through to her feet, just like a photocopying machine. And I said to the lady, get up now. I believe in the supernatural. When we talk about stories like that, we almost try to make it everything spiritual in there. No, it was a physical light that came and went all through this woman's body. I have a sense it was the Holy Ghost doing a super scan on this woman and curing everything that needed curing instantaneously. Her right leg, I think her right leg was gangrene, and to save her life, they were going to amputate the leg. And then here comes the miracle. Hallelujah. Here comes a miracle. Amazing miracle. The lady, I said to her, get up from your bed. And the lady just laid there, and she just turned and put the dead leg on the ground and stood up, and she started walking around that room. What a marvel. Hallelujah. 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 You see, I like what Pastor Lewis says. You don't go to the battle. You don't go to the battle, to the battlefield and ask for weapons. We are the weapons that destroy the enemy. That's right. We are sharpened before we show up. That's why you get the word of God in you. I'm going to give you three keys that guarantees your result in prayer. Hallelujah. Are you ready for that today? Because I believe that today you are going to be walking in absolute victory. You will learn how to pray with faith. To Christ you come. You come to God on the basis of Jesus and what is done. When you come to Him, you come to the Father in the name of Jesus. I'm going to give you three simple ideas. When you pray, you know you can depend on the three simple keys. What are keys? You see, keys are things that unlock treasures, unlock doors, that unlock amazing things. That's what I'm talking about today. You begin to have spiritual insight on unlocking everything around you. Nothing is hid from you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can find grace. Now, this lady walked around and she was completely healed, and that was the first encounter Apostle Everton had with me. And then when we came to the meeting in the Glad Tidings Church in Vancouver, tremendous miracles. They had about five rows of sick Indians, wonderful people that had come because some of their members had been healed, and in Victoria, British Columbia, tremendous miracles. Tremendous. And one of their guys Sanjit was his name, and Sanjit was healed of cancer and then came and told a story. And so all of the community, the East Indian community, they all came out to the meeting and took over the first five rows of this big church in Vancouver. And one of the miracles there was a 15-year-old boy that was born blind. Hallelujah. He was born blind, completely blind from birth. And this is what happened when we came. Miracles everywhere. Apostle Everton was catching for me at the time. And as he watched this miracle, this little boy was in the corner crying with his mother. And the pastor called me and said, you have to take a look at this. Please, come on, take a look at this. This is an amazing miracle. And I came to the corner there. And this little boy, 15 years old, born blind, weeping with his mother. The mother just grabbed him so closely, and they were weeping and weeping. And they said, and the pastor said, this young man was born blind. So I was looking around for the person that was born blind, because I thought maybe the person is still trying to see. No, I just saw this young boy crying with his mother, and I was like, where is the boy? Where is the boy? And they showed me where the boy was. It was amazing. And I looked at him. I looked at the mother. I was standing on the stage. I said, he was born blind? The mother said, yes, he was born blind. And I said, wow, you mean this young man was born blind? He said, yes, this young man was born blind. I said, what is that? He'll point to it. Whatever I pointed to, he pointed to it. And I said, okay, can you see me? He said, yes, he's crying. And I said, I did this. I said, do what I'm doing. He did exactly what I was doing. And I waved, and he waved. So I was wearing my suit, and I said to him, what color of suit am I wearing? And the young man's answer proved to me he was born blind. He said to me, what is color? He was born blind, so he doesn't know color. When he said that, it came very naturally to him. He said, because if he had said black, I would have said, oh, how do you know it is black? He said, what is color? And boy, we just wept. I just hugged this young man. What a glorious thing. But how does this happen? It begins in prayer. When you are praying always in the Spirit. When you're praying always in the Spirit. I'm telling you, there are strategies. There are dimensions of prayer. That's praying with your understanding, praying in the Spirit. I was sharing this with you, and I hope you can stick with me all through this week. It is going to be fantastic. I have a whole teaching on prayer that you guys can avail yourself of. Hopefully, we can get those things as soon as possible. But it has been tremendous what God has been doing in this day to bring this to you. You see, how did, what weapons do you have? What are the keys that guarantees result? I say to you, I was going to give you some things. I have so many things that I want to share with you, but you are on the winning team. The first thing you have to understand that guarantees result is using the name. Using the name of Jesus. When you understand what that name means, that name is the Word of God. If you're going to pray, you have to use that name. That name is the guarantee that unlocks your prayer. Now, when you say, in the name of Jesus, it's like when I say, in the name of the president, it's like the president himself coming there and telling you, you are free, or something. When I use the name, I am invoking the presence of the one I am invoking. Just the same way when a witch doctor invokes the ancestral spirit, or they invoke certain things, they are calling the spirit or calling those things into the present to have their power execute what the will of the person is. So when I say in the name of Jesus in prayer, all of heaven bows to that name. All of heaven bows to that name. That name is your signature. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Bible says, ask anything in my name, I will do it. Hallelujah. So when you come in prayer, you come in the name of Jesus. That, and you know what I said to you many times? I've said to you, whatever you do in word or in deed, you do it in that name. What does that mean when you come to pray in the name of Jesus? Whatever you do in word or in action, do it in that name. You are baptized already into the name. Realize that. Know you are already in the name. So when I come to God, I don't try to just invoke the name. I already know I am already invoked in the name. I hope you understand what I'm talking about. I hope you understand what I'm talking about today. What I'm talking about is understanding that when I come, I know I'm already in that name. Whatever I do in word or in deed, I am already in that name. That name gives me access to everything. That is my signature. That is my PIN code. When I call that name, you see, I can say the name of God, and it could mean different things to different people, but when I say the name of Jesus, the demons know it was the person of Jesus, because there's something when I come in the name, it tells you that that name represents the person. So when I say Jesus, Jesus appears. He comes on the scene. He says, I am there. Call on me and I will answer. Hallelujah. When I call that name of Jesus, he shows up to handle the business. So he comes in my prayer as my ever present high priest. When I say in the name of Jesus, my high priest comes and he carries out his mandate. Hallelujah. There is power in that name. I see Magdalene, bless you, sweetie. Miss you very much in Rhode Island. You see, when you call that name in prayer, demons tremble. Demons don't care when you say in the name of God, in the name of anything, but when you say the name of Jesus, have you ever realized that whenever you use the name of Jesus, you cause a lot of stirring in the religious circle? All of a sudden they said, just use a neutral name. God is not neutral. Jesus is not neutral. Use that name of Jesus and demons would tremble at that name. Hallelujah. You call that name and something happens. Even all heaven must stand at attention at the mention of the name of Jesus. When you pray, pray in the name. Come in the name of Jesus. Come wrapped up in that name. Wrapped up in that name. And heaven will grant you access to the very presence of the King. When I come to him, I come in his name. I go in his name. Whatever I do in prayer, in word, or in deed, I do it in that name. That is one of the keys that unlocks your prayer life. When you come in the name of Jesus, you know you have access to the King. Do you understand what I'm talking about today? Hallelujah. I see Bolu, welcome on board. Hallelujah. Now, what am I talking about today? I'm talking about understanding how to guarantee success when you pray. The first thing I mentioned to you is to Christ you come. Number one, the access way to God is through Jesus. Number two, God is not dumb. God speaks and he answers, and he speaks to you today. Believe that. I said number three, behold Jesus. When I come to him, I look to Jesus, not to anything else, not to anybody else, but to Jesus. So I give you the first key to a successful or a prayer that is guaranteed results is to come in the name of Jesus. When you come in that name, demons tremble. When you come in that name, victory is assured. When you come in that, you come wrapped up in that name, something amazing begins to take place. You begin to find that you are walking in victory every single day. I told you guys, I'm not religious. I just know that Jesus is real. Is he real to you? Is he real to you, my friends? Is Jesus real to you? Or is it just something you do on a Sunday? Jesus is real to me. I'm talking about coming in the name of Jesus. When you come in that name, something amazing begins to take place. And what does that mean? You are baptized in that name. The Bible says whatever you do in word or in deed, you do in that name. Now, let me give you some things about why you use the name of Jesus. When you use the name of Jesus, you are calling into the present reality all that he is and all that he has and all he can do. Now, let me explain that. All that he is the king. All that he has all power. All that he can do anything. Hallelujah. Do you get that? All that he is the king. And when he speaks, nobody can say to him, why did he say that? And all that he has all power. That means when I come in that name, I have all that he is, all that he has, and all that he can do wrapped up in that name. I hope you get what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. When you come in the name of Jesus, why? Let me give it why those three things are important. All that he is. Do you know that Jesus got his name? Let's look at Philippians chapter 2. I want to read something to you that can help you very much. Philippians chapter 2. The Bible says in verse 5, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. It is not robbery to be on the class of God. It is not robbery to think like God thinks and to talk like God talks or to act like God acts. But he made himself of no reputation. In other words, you are not looking at reputation. You are looking at truth. Reputations are made and destroyed day in and day out. But if reputation is your concern, you will never have a long-lasting reputation. Build character and reputation will take care of itself. Hallelujah. Let the character of Jesus be built on the inside of you. Think, talk, and act like him. And then don't worry about reputation. Just be concerned about let the character of God in you be revealed to the world. He made himself of no reputation. He took upon him the form of a servant. He brought himself to the place where he was compassionate to us, and he was made in the likeness of men. He was made in the likeness of men. Verse 8, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death on the cross. Let's go to verse 9. Wherefore, God has highly exalted him. Now pay attention why the name of Jesus is important. Why, when you come in prayer, I'm talking about how to pray with faith, unleashing prayer power. Most people come and just say, in the name of Jesus, Father. Listen to me. Let's not get into rituals now, because I know people say, Father, in the name of Jesus. No, when I say, in the name of Jesus, is different from being in panic mode. In the name of Jesus, oh Father, please, in the name of Jesus. I'm saying to you, when I say, in the name of Jesus, I have a revelation behind that name. When I say to the blind, in the name of Jesus, be healed. I know what I'm invoking. I'm not just saying, in the name of Jesus, just so something might happen. When I say, in the name of Jesus, behind my saying, in the name of Jesus, is this revelation that releases the power. I know I come in his name. When I say in the name of Jesus, it is done. Case closed. I don't have to repeat the name of Jesus 10 times. When I say in the name of Jesus, it is done. Case closed. End of story. I don't have to yell and scream. I just said, in the name of Jesus, come out. That's all I have to do. I don't have to be yelling and screaming like I'm a crazy person like the devil. No, I don't have to do that, because I have a revelation of that name. Do you have a revelation of that name? I'm giving you three keys that can guarantee success when you pray. You come in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in verse 9, God had highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every other name. Verse 10, that he, first of all, verse 9, he gave him a name above every other name. So when I call the name of Jesus, that name is above every other name. When I come in the name of Jesus, that name is above every other name. When I act in the name of Jesus, it is above every other authority you can find. So when I come in prayer, I come on the basis of that name. Demons tremble at the sound of that name. We have a wonderful song we used to sing many years ago, by David Ingalls. Demons are helpless at the sound of that name. they still remembered Jesus put them to shame. And then the song goes on to say, all hell must tremble, for they must obey him. And heaven stands at attention when I mention that name. What a beautiful song. That song was just coming my spirit, and I was smiling when I was talking about the power of the name. When I come in prayer, I come in the name of Jesus with confidence, knowing this, that heaven hears me. God hears me. The Bible says, wherefore God exalted him and given him a name which is above every other name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee, cancer must bow, diabetes must bow, poverty must bow. Whatever name you can call will bow when you come in that name. Hallelujah. Of things in heaven. That means whatever name, do you know God's name is not the highest name in heaven? The name that's highest in heaven is Jesus. God is revealed in Jesus. That's a whole other teaching I'll share with you some other time. Do you know God's name, all through the Old Testament, God was revealing his attributes to people, and the people were getting an idea of who God was, and they're getting excited. And he said, when my people, Isaiah says, when my people shall know my name. He says, my name is being blasphemed every day. My name is being blasphemed every day. And the Bible says, in the place where I will put my name. Oh my goodness, you guys are trying to pull something out of me. Where he has put his name? Where has he put his name? I see Pastor Team. Hallelujah. We can't wait to see you at the Power School. He has put his name in Jesus. I'm talking about unleashing prayer power. He has put his name in Jesus. He's not put his name in any other thing. The name that God wants to be known is the name of Jesus. The Bible declares that of things in heaven, and of things in the earth, and of things underneath the earth. That means when I say Jesus in heaven, heaven bows and heaven stands at attention and say, indeed, that is the name that is higher than any other name. In other words, all through the Old Testament, God was revealing himself by different attributes. He says, I am Jehovah Rapha. He says, I'm Jehovah Sikkenu. I am Jehovah that does this, that does that. But his name, what was his name? The Bible says God has used that name, the name of Jesus, an exalted name. When you come in prayer, come on the basis of that name. You will have boldness and access by faith with confidence in that name. When you come, that is one of the secrets to having your prayer successful. When you come on the basis of the revelation of that name, I come in his name and I have a right to be heard by my Father. My Father hears me always. We read that scripture yesterday that God hears us. If we have the confidence he hears us, we know we have the petition of whatever we ask. I hope that this is helping you today, understanding that the name of Jesus is the name that's above every other name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. I'm talking about three keys that guarantee success when you pray. Number one is the name of Jesus. Come and on the basis of that name. That name, because what does that mean? That name declares who he is. He is the king. Number two, what he has all power. Number three, and what he can do, there is nothing too hard for him to do. As I'm speaking, there's somebody that has your femur. You have a pain in your femur. God is healing you completely. In the name of Jesus, that broken bone is healed right now. I just want to show you how it works. Somebody with diabetes is being healed now in the name of Jesus. As I speak, the diabetes is being completely removed from your system. Somebody with a blood condition is being healed. I can see also somebody with a disease spell. That thing is gone from you in the name of Jesus. When I say that name, something is released and all of hell trembles at the sound of that name. At the sound of that name, all of hell trembles. That's what I'm talking about today. When you understand that name, you understand who he is, what he has, and what he can do. That's the key. I come on the basis of that name. Whenever I come to a meeting and I hear people say, we have to fight, we have to do this, we have to come, the devil is doing this, I smile. I say, wait until I use that name. wait until I use that name. That's called the nuclear button. When I push that name, Jesus, it's over for the devil. Hallelujah. So sometimes I don't even have to say that name. I just come in that name. Hallelujah. I just say, freeze, devil. This is the kingdom. The kingdom now reigns. Hallelujah. Now you get out. Hallelujah. Do you understand what I'm talking about? I come in that name. In that name of Jesus today, to tell you that this is going to be a glorious week for you. That means every situation that has kept you bound and has kept you down, it's turned around in your favor in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, that means whatever thing that you were struggling with, that finances you've been waiting for, it's released to you now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Boy, I can go a little more in depth to talk to you about these keys. I'm going to stick with just key number one today, and that is the name of Jesus and prayer. When you understand this, my dear friends, it changes everything you know about prayer. I don't come struggling. I come on the basis of that name. The Bible says my name is being blasphemed every day, but when my people shall know, that means shall know my name. You can be using the name without knowledge. Like some people use the name of Jesus, a swear word, but a man or woman that has a revelation of that name changes the story. How did Jesus acquire this name? First of all, it was given to him by his Father God. His name shall be called Jesus, for he shall save his people. Hallelujah. It was given to him by inheritance. By inheritance. That means if the name is inherited, I am Charles Senior, my son is Charles Junior. So if he inherited my name, that means my name. If his name is Charles, that name means my name is Charles. If they ask Charles Junior, what's your name? He said, my name is Charles. How did you get the name? I inherited the name from my father. Then they don't have to ask the next question, what is your father's name? If he inherited the name from his father, then the mystery revealed is Jehovah, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Messiah. Jehovah, our Savior, the Messiah. Hallelujah. That is the key. Jehovah, our Savior. He has come to save us from everything that needs to be saved. And he has already saved us and has redeemed us in him. Hallelujah. I hope you got what I'm talking about today. Hallelujah. What am I saying to you? When you understand this, your prayer life changes. You're no longer yelling and screaming at demons. You no longer, I just come as the devil back off. When I pray, I just said, Father, I'm so thankful that you always hear me. Later on this week, we're going to be talking about dimensions of prayer. There's a time you pray. The Bible says through prayer and supplication. But also, you have a time when you're praying to create. You're praying creative prayers when you're creating a brand new world with your prayers. You understand that when you're doing this, you are releasing words energized with the power of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Keys that unlock your prayer life. Unleashing prayer's power. When you understand this, your prayer changes. You stop struggling and just repeating mantras. I read yesterday from Matthew chapter 6. Jesus said, don't be like the publican, like the Pharisees. They think that by praying loud in public, then no, they'll be heard by many people. They have their reward. But when you pray, you go into your secret place. Your place of secret, where you are initiated in that place. You are in the place of fellowship with your Father. And then when you pray, there's a release of dynamic force that changes everything around you. First of all, when you're praying in that place, in that secret place, something is happening. There is something. The Bible says that your heavenly Father will reward you. There is reward in praise. I hope you understand what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Your words energized with the power of God coming and changing the world around you. Hallelujah. Now somebody say to me, but we have to pray and yell and scream. I say, if you want to do that, feel free. But that's not for me. I learned something different. I can talk to God. I don't need to yell and shout at God. Hallelujah. Now somebody said, but we have to shout and shout at the enemy. I said, no. I used to do that before I knew that the enemy was defeated. I realized, why should I shout at a stupid devil? He knows who knows him. He knows who has power over him. It's a Jesus I know, Paul I know, Charles I know. Put your name in that list and let's have fun and kick the devil out. Hallelujah. I see my baby. I see Mariah. Welcome. I'm talking about unleashing prayer's power. My goodness. I'm talking about when you understand the name, you understand three things about the name, that when you invoke the name, he comes in that name. When I say Jesus, he shows up. Why? Number one, who he is. Number two, what he has. Number three, what he can do comes in alignment at that moment when I come in that name. Whosoever name you come in invokes the power of that name. Hallelujah. So when we come, we unleashing prayer power. So I know sometimes people, when they come in prayer, they're yelling and screaming. You don't have to do that. Sometimes you say, first of all, I don't need to yell to God. He hears me. That's the confidence I have. Then I don't need to yell at the devil. He knows me. Hallelujah. You see, God knows me. God hears me. Satan knows me. And Satan can hear me. Sometimes I just said, hey, little devil, now back away from the people. And when I say that, something happens. And it is glorious what God does. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Hallelujah. So we are sticking just to hearing what we are talking about today, unleashing prayer's power. Hallelujah. See, when I speak to you, something is released in the atmosphere. I say to you, when I say in the name of Jesus, behind my saying it, there must be a revelation of that name. Because when I say Jesus, he shows up. When I call your name, you answer. And you call. It's a call upon me in the days of trouble. I will deliver you. I will answer you. When you call, he shows up. In other words, he is in his name. When you use the name of Jesus, he is in that name. Hallelujah. When you come in the name of Jesus, he comes in that name. You come in that name and you can unleash the power of that name. I said he got his name by conquest, he got it by inheritance, and also it was bestowed to him by his father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So when we understand that name, it changes how we pray. My prayer today is that you get a revelation of that name in prayer. When you pray, just come to Christ, you come. Number two, God is not dumb. God speaks today. And number three, behold Jesus. Behold the Son. You want to behold Jesus today. Hallelujah. Number three, behold Jesus. Number four, see what he has done. What does that mean? I see redemption in completeness. I don't see anything left to be undone. The only part I have to play is to finish what he started, to continue and set the people free around me. Hallelujah. I said, Nisha, welcome on board. Hallelujah. Number five, he is for everyone. The good news we bring, what I'm telling you today, he is for everyone. When you come in faith to pray, how you can unleash faith in prayer, you come, he is there for you. The gospel is a power of God for the salvation for everyone who would believe. You are included today. I hope that this has helped you today and you can walk with your head held up high, not worrying about somebody trying to make you feel like you haven't qualified to be in the presence of God. Hear what I said to you yesterday. I say to you, you are heard of God. You're not trying to get God's attention. No, God already is attentive to you. He attends to the cries of his people. Hallelujah. See, that's the confidence we have. When we have this confidence, the results are different. When we were in Nigeria, I was telling them and demonstrating tumors disappearing instantaneously. 15 people completely healed. The tumors disappeared, or the cancers disappeared, and the people were miraculously healed. And then there was a lady, I was looking at some of the pictures last night. Tremendously, all of a sudden, the lump that she had was gone. A lady with an issue of blood, instantaneously it disappeared. We don't have to make a ritual out of that. We have the power of that name. When you come to people, come and love them. I hope this has helped you today to understand keys that unlocks faith in prayer. And key number one is come in the name of Jesus. I hope this has helped you today. I know we are going to be doing a lot more. We're going to be getting a lot more other things. Yeah, we're going to be getting you involved in other things. But I hope that this has been able to bless you very, very much today. Okay? So let me just get this done a little better. So hear this. I want to encourage you today. If you know this has been a blessing to you, it's helped you, I want you to go to our website, register. Number one, register for Power School. Number two, I want you to sow an uncommon seed today. Let us release the power of revelation. I realize this, whenever we sow a seed, we are partnering with the grace of what we have heard. If this has blessed you today, whatever seed it is, go and release an uncommon seed so that you can have the same grace of what God has given us in this revelation of the faith of Jesus. Amen. I want to encourage you. You go to christlove.org and you can sow your seed. Let's get this message to every corner of the globe. That is our mission. I know we cannot do that by ourselves. That's why God needs you. You come in as God's partners. You can go out, help people. We're doing some amazing things this year. We're going to be going very soon. And I'm going to graduation this weekend. It's just going to be fantastic. Well, Philip is graduating for Bible school. I'm going to be hanging out with some of my friends. Hallelujah. Brother Rodney Howard Brown and all those guys. We're going to be having fun this week. So, hallelujah. They have a camp meeting going on. And we're going to be there. But we're going to be doing Daily Boost just as usual. I want to encourage you today. Sow a seed. Let's get the gospel out. We're going to be in Kenya. We're going to be in Uganda. You need to get yourself in the flow. Hopefully we're going to be in Brazil in September. Let's get things ready because we are on a roll with what God has in store for us. I want to thank all of you for supporting what God is doing in this ministry. You know, we couldn't do it without your support, without your help. It's your seed. People like you that believe in the mission of this ministry. That's why we bring this thing to you for free. We don't ask you to get into a list and then you have to pay money to listen to this. We give it to you for free because we believe that you are benefiting from it. And that is our mission. That is our goal. Thank you for your support constantly in this ministry. I want to say you are loved. Oh my goodness. Nisha. That's my baby girl. Love you. Dr. Nisha, okay. Oh my goodness. I love you guys so much. Hallelujah. And I see my son Ernest Boateng. I love you. We missed you on this last trip. We had a great time in Africa. And Maria, God bless you. And we see Princess Lucy. I love you. Love you, love you. All of my wonderful sons and daughters. We have hallelujah. Chris from Dexter, Iowa. Riziki Kimono, God bless you. I see Heavenly. All of you are still on board. Hallelujah. My goodness. And I see Tia. Tia is watching. I love you. We miss you. Your birthday was just a couple of weeks ago. God bless you. We are so glad. And we have Kathleen. Kathy, we go a long way, way back. My goodness. This is wonderful. I am honored to have all of you on board today. Wow, wow, wow. Alexander, we have Birgit, we have Medina. Oh my goodness. We have Medina, God bless you. And Evangelist Elijah, God bless you. Wow, I'm just going through the list of people that are here today. My goodness, my goodness. We are doing, hopefully, you know, just let me know you like the setup here. It's going to be great. We do it. We have a lot of things coming up, some surprises for you. We have some other shows that we'll be putting up together. Our guys are working, Tyler, Oren, everybody's working diligently. We're setting up some of the sets and things. We need to get those things finished. That way you can come. Don't forget to register for Power School. We are going to have a fun time at the Power School of Miracles. Don't think about it. Just register and come. The hotels, we have a great rate with them. If they say they're out of rooms, let us know. We'll get those things done for you. We'll make sure we can get the rooms for you. Register and join us at the Power School. July 22nd to 28th. It is going to be a phenomenal time of revelation. 1 week of just marinating. God spoke to me this year. You're going to manifest. You're going to manifest everything he's spoken about you. This is your year of extraordinary exploits. You are going to manifest that. And when we come in July, I'm going to be giving you uncommon keys to shining. Hallelujah. So you don't want to miss that. You want to register and come to the Power School. And I'm looking forward to all of you that have joined me today. I love you. Thank you for your support of this ministry. We're looking forward to an extraordinary day tomorrow. And tonight, I'll be in Taunton, Massachusetts. You don't want to miss it. Those of you that are in New England close by, you want to come there and support what we're doing. It starts at 7 o'clock tonight. It is at the Cathedral of Life with Apostle Ivan Kotz, 336 Ware Street in Taunton, Mass. And I want to invite you to come there. You can call the number 617-427, I believe it's 8975. Call them up and tell them you want to come and be part of something uncommon tonight. I'm going to be there tonight, just one night only. It is going to be glorious. Again, I want to say thank you all for supporting the ministry. Go and sow something uncommon, and I look forward to seeing you guys very soon. God bless you, and I'll see you tonight and tomorrow. God bless you.